Evan, you've been talking to your sources. What is the working theory right now about what Nunes is talking about when he keeps talking about incidental collection?
Right. Well, Aaron, the leading theory among officials who I've been talking to, and again, Chairman Nunes has not given them any information. They still don't know exactly what he's talking about. But one of the things that they could they believe this could be is the collection that the U.S. intelligence agencies do on foreign leaders and their staff. These are foreign countries that are routinely monitored as part of U.S. surveillance, foreign surveillance, and its intelligence collection. And we're talking about the leaders of Israel, of Taiwan, of China, of Russia. These are the countries that the U.S. most has its eyes on. And we know that during the Trump transition, they had calls with the setting up calls for the president-elect, the incoming president, to talk to those foreign leaders. And so you have interaction there, and the U.S. would routinely pick up the communications of those people. If they were, for instance, communicating with each other, talking about the Trump transition or talking about the new president, Trump, this is stuff that the U.S. would routinely pick up, and an NSA analyst would look at this and perhaps summarize it for an intelligence report. Now, we know a couple of different instances during the Trump transition that really raised questions. One of them was the time that the President Trump intervened with Egyptian leaders and Israeli leaders about this U.N. vote on Israel, if you remember.
Yep.
And the second one was when President Trump, the incoming president, took a phone call from the Taiwanese leader. These are definite instances where this would be collected.
Right, and of course, he didn't do it through the traditional State Department ways. It was
exactly.
Off the cuff, and perhaps this is what happens when you don't do it and play by the rules.